come here. Look, coaches, if you see children doing that, it's a problem. The hurley is too heavy. They have to prop it up with this hand, you get it? And now they're gimped. They should be fully free here. Okay? And as coaches going around, two hands on the hurley at all times. Well, this is quite tricky, isn't it? And then somebody does it and you give out to them. Because we're seeing all cans from 1910. Okay, so the girl is expected to run, turn, skip, strike, catch. Get out of the way because the whistle is going for the other person. And if they blow the ear off you, it is your own ear will be gone. Which way are you going to run? Like a crab or like a horse? That's the way you run, yeah? I know we're by the sea. Don't let her run side us now anymore. She's her own zone. On the whistle! Who knows about whistles? Did you say sorry to me?
Sorry.
I saw you not saying sorry. Now talk to her about turning. Turn your body. Well, girl, brilliant strike. Brilliant. Lads, will you stay with the whistle or for God's sake somebody get a broken elbow? The last thing I want, girls, is somebody with a broken elbow here. Stay between your collars. Stay. That's your Lena. Go on down straight. Now you're safe. Everybody's safe. Coaches, they should be streamlined like this on the strike. That's the way they should be. They should be here like this with their back to you. And at the strike, they should be side to you. And immediately they strike, they're following through for the catch. Got it? Okay, demonstrate, run, turn, skip, strike, catch, brilliant strike, that's fantastic. That's even better than I hoped for. So if the ball comes back over your head, you know your alignment was good. Good girl, let it on, what are you stopping it for? Now get him to turn his body now, get it sideways to the wall. Good boy, well struck. That's a good boy. What side of the ball is that? If that hits somebody, will it kill him? No, soft. Who's on the whistle there? A black card or a white card or a yellow one? Now get her sideways. Coaches, talk about the swing now. 30 seconds, talk about the complete swing. Lock out, front of the eyes. Lock out, elbow up. Get up that elbow, and away we go. Get out that elbow when you're striking. Pick up that elbow, and that'll give you the stroke. Pick up that right wing. Pick up the right wing when you're striking right, and tuck this one in. Now you have it. Now you'll strike, no bother. Ready to go? Watch here. If the child is striking right, the right wing comes up. If she's striking left, so the wing near you comes up. The wing will come up. If it's not coming up, the girl is compromised. The swing won't be there. Okay, girls and boys, we're ready to go. Now, do you understand about getting your body right up? So settle yourself down and do it. Lovely hurdle. Brilliant. That's lovely now. Well, you pick up the ball off the ground instead of fooling around on the ground. Pick it up with your hand. Do you know what your hand is? Mia, you'd have saved me now 17 touches if you had to pick it up with your hand. 17 touches later, she got it into her hand. Stand there now. Coaches, watch here.
Stay there now.
Watch here. The child coming in, front leg to the wall, and doesn't know about front foot, and you get that. All weight on the foot near the wall. All weight is coming onto the knee, the foot at the wall. All the weight is coming onto the front one. Did you pick that? All weight is coming onto the foot near the wall. That's what they're talking about, the front foot. Now try that again. Okay, so all your weight of your body comes onto the foot that's near the wall. That stabilizes you, and this one can follow on if it likes. You're almost there now. You're almost there. Good. Now, coming lovely. Coming lovely. Well done. You got your structure right there now. It doesn't matter if Paudie has missed the ball 20 times. I don't care. You have your structure now. Now, let the hurley go. Don't hold back. When you're swinging, let it off. Swing it again. Let it off. That's it. Don't hold back. Okay? Good girl. That's super now. That's superb. Now, shorten your hurley. There's nothing wrong there now. Shorten your hurley. Come here. There's nothing wrong with your structure, but you have a long hurley and you're addicted out there. Shorten in here and bring it in near your body. Bring it in here near you. Okay. Good girl. Good girl. Good. Let it go. It's lovely. It's lovely. Okay. Are we going to go? Can we go quite fast now for a while? I'm going to blow the whistle very regular. When you're in the way or out of the way, I'm going to blow the whistle. Ready? Front foot, front foot, front foot, front foot. All weight on the front foot. Help her with the feet. Help her with the feet. Get the front foot. Go back now and start again. Next whistle. Get ready. Ready for the whistle. Okay. Girls. Okay. Some people coach girls as if they weren't players. And they get them to do that instead of letting them enjoy themselves. Let it on. Let it on there. You're not going to hurt anybody because it comes back into you. That hurley won't hurt anybody. That'll hurt somebody. So let the hurley go through, girls. Don't be holding on to it, okay? Different stroke. Trying to be nice. No good. Okay? Different class now. Pick it up with your hand. Good boy. Try and round up that swing now in a minute. You're going fine. Try and round the swing. Hey. Brilliant. Catch now. Good girl, well done. So 50% of the people now are on correct technique. So we're at tipping point here. All we have to do is keep supporting. It's amazing how much they learn by watching the person in front of them. So if you have a person that isn't able to do it, get the person in front of them who is able to do it. And they watch and they learn from each other instead of preaching all the time. Sometimes I have to mix them up now, do you understand me? I'd have to put one person from another line into another line. I want you here. Okay, I missed your name again.
Liam.
Thanks, Liam. Now, so there you are, Liam. Okay, so make sure they're hurling at right angles. Did you get onto the front foot? And did you trust yourself with a lovely round swing? Okay, Liam. Now, you have the round swing now. So give me the ball. Pretend now you have a beautiful round swing now. The ball is only distracting you. Stay with the lovely round swing. Keep your eye on it now. Keep your eye on the ball. You keep your eye on the ball, your body will respond. Run. Turn. I don't think your eyes on the ball. Now keep your eye on the ball and everything will be good. Okay, stand behind me. Coach, let him in beside you there. Talk him through me. Out here. Whisper in as I go. So the first thing is, up to Thurles Saturday and get a euro for it, thank God. 50 cents, anything at all, but don't ever mind it anyway. So here we go. He needs to move forward, ball in the hand, nice and tidy, anybody could snig it. Okay, he now needs to get to that position. Run out there, get to that position, round swing. And the ball should come back dead straight. If his alignment is right, the ball should come back. If the alignment is right, the ball has to come back straight. Do you understand it now? So if the ball is not coming back straight, one leg has let him down. See this leg? Where will the ball go? See it? Simple enough. So the guide here, if the ball is coming back, especially if it comes over the child's head and they're giving out to themselves, that's a brilliant ball. So don't give out to yourself for the brilliant ones. Liam, do you understand me?
Yeah.
Coach, did you help? Thank you so much. This is your hand for the ball. And that's called a hurley. Right? Now, away you go. The swing is good. Go again now. Just keep your eye on. I knew you weren't keeping your eye on the ball. Just saw your eyes on the ball. Saw your eyes to the ball. So that's his only weakness, that he wasn't keeping his eye on the ball. He was looking up. He was unsure. He was watching the wall. Like people watching the goalpost in a match. They look up to see the goalpost. They don't get the shot. Will you try that again now? Saw your eyes to the ball. So this is what we do for people who don't keep their eyes on the ball. Okay? So I'm going to put two letters on this. Letter C and letter T. And he has to tell me which one he saw last before he struck it. That'll focus him on something and distract his mind from looking up. That's what tennis players do, okay? In order to distract our minds from fright and fear, he now has a task. And if you see neither, that could happen too. You understand the task? Okay. What did you see? Now do you see the difference? I distracted him from his worries, I focused him on the ball, but I have a way of focusing. Instead of saying three F's and four curses, yeah, I gave him something. Is that okay? So now watch your child, see is it, are they not watching the ball, or what's causing them not to get so much satisfaction. Are we ready to go? Is that your ball? Doubtful.
No.
Are we ready?
What is it?
Coaches, 5 seconds of coaching before I blow the whistle. Five? Is it 5 minutes?
Or ten, whatever you
ten,
want.
Ten, yeah, good, good, good. Coach, thanks. That's just supreme. That's just the image this child wants. Supreme, well done. Ready, lad? Do you understand what we're looking for? Now, children, we're just above the crossbar. We're just above the crossbar. And if the ball comes over your helmet, don't block it. That's a good shot. If you're able to catch it, do, but if you're not, let it back to the coach behind. Now, starting your hurley now, it's a little bit offline. Hurley's a bit too long for you.
Yeah.
Now you'll be okay. Now, to see the difference, things are beginning to motor, aren't they?
Yeah.
Now, with that shot, she'll fall in love with Camogie and she'll play forever. Because that's what we play for, isn't it? Person goes out playing golf, can't hit the ball, they chuck it, don't they? Person goes playing tennis, can't hit the ball, they chuck it. In Camogie, if we can't hit the ball, we won't sustain it. That's what sustains us. Beautiful. You need to say that to her. Beautiful. That was just a beautiful stroke. Now go again, Petra. Just hit the ball off the hurley. That's an accident. Go again there for yourself. That'll just happen now and again. Keep the two of them separated. Now, you see the lovely shot you got now? So don't let the hurley come too near you there. Don't let the ball, because it could hit off that and then you're done. So keep them away from each other. Go again. Now, you see the lovely enjoyment of that? Now let it off. Let it off. You're holding it a little bit. Let it on. No need to hold it. Now, would you be able to come there? So you're coming from here. You don't trust yourself. Can you come there? Could you come there? Try it without the ball. Move forward when you're doing it. Go on, move forward again. Come back to me and move forward. So you have to get, you have it in you now. It's just to trust yourself. Okay. Let it off, but let the hurley go. Right, coaches. For the very, there's about 40 strokes in hurley, but the very basic stroke is struck almost off the knee. It's struck about knee high. If the girls and boys start striking off the shoulder, that's a stroke, but it's an emergency stroke. And when there's not an emergency, we strike the ball around knee, the ball leaves my hurley at knee high. Now a lot of them here are at hip high, which is okay. Some of them are at shoulder high, all okay. But you're much better off dropping the ball down to knee high. Drop it down. You see the difference in the stroke? There's a tidiness starts coming into it. There's a bit of wristiness starts comes into it. Get it down there. Now notice your children now, are they shoulder, hip, or are they down to the knee? And help them through the process of bringing the ball down to the knee. Did you get me, boys and girls? Yeah. Liam, try that, off the knee, shorten your stick. Where do you strike the ball, coaches? Shoulder high. He doesn't understand, he does in his mind, but he didn't in his body. So we have to bring it from his mind right down into his body. We want you striking the ball knee high. You understand the words? But you may not do it. You understand? He may not do it. It isn't that he doesn't want it. It's not that he's bold. The old habit overpowers him. Okay. Get it down to your knee. Where does he strike the ball? Shoulder high. Now you understand how coaches have work to do. You see where the work comes? We start noticing more. So children, this is a change now. So bring your body, fold it up, get it onto his chair. Get it onto his chair, fold that bottom, and now we get a bit of something on the ball. We get a bit of body on the ball. And when you get body and wrist together, it is hard to play any other sport. The enjoyment is massive. Are you able to come this? Coaches, we have 6 minutes left to get this done. Okay. I waited until the children's confidence is high to do this. It's the final step for today, isn't it? Okay. So again, we want the child to fold these muscles have to fold. Strike the ball hip high, strike the ball knee high, trying to get it up to the crossbar from the knee high, trying to get it up there. Now there's a bit of work there, coaches, for us, because the children now are going to go back a bit. They're going to have failure now. You understand, children? It could cause you to go back. Oh, I'll go back to my old way. Don't. Try and learn the new way because you'll enjoy yourself more. Okay, we have 5 more minutes now, coaches. Coach like hell. Now, if there are 3 knees in their body, tell them that this is their knee, and this is their hip knee, and this is their shoulder knee. Yeah, kind of new kind of animals in Clonakilty with 3 knees. Shorten your stick. Goodbye. Goodbye. Shorten your stick. You don't need that distance. You're just on the edge of the square. He's just on the edge of the square in the real field. Understand? He might think he's a bit out. Now, where did you strike that one? How high was it? How high was that one? When you hit it, where were you? Hip high? Yeah, the coach will know. Yeah, he was close enough, wasn't he? He's making great progress. Yeah, he has a lovely swing. Now where did he strike it? Shoulder high. So this is the boy with the 3 knees. He has a knee up here, and he has a knee here, and his knee, and his knee hip, and his knee shoulder.
That's it.
Where did you strike it? Belly high. Yeah, hip high. Good man. He's getting aware now. He's now aware. Awareness is first. Can we tidy up his, can we round his swing? Get the hurley across your eyes there. Put it down to the knee. Good girl. You see the difference? Enjoyment increases. Now where did you strike the ball? Shoulder high. Yeah, that's your shoulder knee. You know your shoulder knee? And your hip knee and your knee.
What?
Come this way. You came from here. I want you coming from here. It's really about sitting on the chair, coaches, isn't it?
Yeah.
Can we sit on the chair and release the muscle? Sit down, release the muscle. Sit down, release the muscle. That's where the enjoyment comes from. Oh, lovely. Now you just work on that. You have it now. Just work on it. Lovely stroke. Where did you strike from? Shoulder. Okay, so you bring her down now, bring the ball down to her knee. It takes patience to let the ball fall that far. And the girl is going to get a fright and she lets rip it when it's here. But that's the basic stroke. And we can have all the other strokes later on. Like, there's nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong with a person racing in a match past the 14-yard line and popping it over the bar. There's nothing wrong with that. Because there's somebody chasing you. But it's not the basics. That's not the basic stroke. That's an emergency stroke that you have to have. But we're not going off teaching that as the basic stroke of hurling. This is the basic stroke. She thought I'd come over and deliver personally. You have another thing coming, girl. Now, where did you strike from? Off the shoulder. So get it down to the knee. Right, now girls, boys, we're ready for the ultimate challenge. We have 4 minutes. So now, okay, this is it. This is the challenge. You race in, jab rise, turn your body and let rip. You got to get the strike away about here. Race in, jab rise, turn your body and let it rip. Put it back there and I'll blow the whistle for safety. Will you have a go? Hurley short. Short. Right, girl. Now get it back to your hand so that you'll be able to put it down. Do you understand, girls? The challenge is pretty big. It's probably everything that's good in hurling, isn't it? Race in, win the ball, turn your body, rip it over the bar. Wow. Yeah. Horse her out of it and get back. Shout! A girl, get your courage up now. Get your courage up. Children, those balls are not going to come back and shoot you. They're dead. Can you see that, coaches? So the girl can have a full ripper here. Come in, win the ball here. Reorganize your body and let it off by here. So really, that's the coaching zone, isn't it, coaches? That's the key point here. Are you ready? So she waddled in. She waddled in case she gets to the ball anyway quick. Why? Because she was scared that she wouldn't be able to do it. So she slows down. Everything slows. So the girls could control us again. It's speed into the ball. Speed on the rise. We did that an hour ago, didn't we? So we're all able to do that. But where's the scare come in? The scare comes in that I won't catch it and I'll run into the wall and bust myself. Shorten your hurley and try that. What did he do? Lost himself. He caught the ball beautifully, perfect to hear. And then the tail wagged the dog, naturally enough. Now doggy, over there, this is the tail, I'll hold on to the tail. So he's coming beautifully. Coming beautifully. Right his body, no. I mean, that's a catastrophe. So rise the ball, switch your body, burst it. You try that again. So I'm going to stand here in case he comes sideways. I'm going to give him the rails like Cheltenham. Do you understand? I'm giving him a rails because he's a good boy and he's entitled to my help. Shorten the stick a fraction. Now, fast in. Fast rise, turn the body. See him on the back foot? That's all he has to learn, everything else is right. Why don't you get onto the front foot now? Children, after the rise, get onto the front foot. Come on, we know all this. After the rise, onto the front foot. Onto the front foot and burst it. Good girl. And burst it. Onto the front foot and burst it. The ball will not come back. It's a dead ball. Burst it. Good girl. Now you're on business. Shorten up that big heavy thing. It's a mile long and it's about a ton weight. Now burst it. Good girl. Good girl. Well done. Now girls, get your confidence up. Run fast, catch fast and strike hard. Onto the front foot. Good girl. Now you're swinging the hurley. Good boy. Now, are you organized this time? Do you need a rail? Coach, give him a rail there. Mind you don't catch the backswing off this boy. Oh, lovely strike. Good man. That's yours? How are you going? Good man. Children, we'd like to see the ball hitting the wall a little bit stronger now. Trust yourself, trust yourself, trust yourself. Get out, win the ball, get your hip to the wall, and let it rip. Now that's fantastic. That is fantastic. Coaches, that's fantastic what you're after doing there. That's just perfect now. Shorten up that hurley, sit down. Fantastic, good girl. Shorten the hurley more. Good girl. Come here. Coming here, strike here. What did you want over there, Fern? That's only an old habit. Okay, keep the line firm. You hold there, she keeps her own line. Your line is your line. It's a straight line, okay? With 2 minutes to go, can we get him up to another level? Strike and catch. Strike and rocket and then catch. So trust yourself now that you're going to hit it really hard, but you're still there, calm for the catch. Now, catch, catch, good girl. Rocket now, catch. And I'll catch for you, okay? Good do with the servant. Did you catch? Long hurley, you can't catch if you have a long hurley, you have to shorten up. Where's your catch gone? Hello? Where's the catch? There is a catch, isn't there? Come on, Liam. That was a good one. Right over your head. Should be nailed, shouldn't it?
Yeah.
Strike was good. Alignment was perfect. Didn't trust yourself. You were a tall boy. You could have caught that handy. Shorten this hurley again. Bring it back for yourself. Short hurley. The tail is wagging the dog here. Under the line now, nice and firm. Good girl, good girl. Keep her eyeing it, keep her eyeing it, keep her eyeing it. Keep her eyeing it. That's the girl, that's the girl. Now next time blasts, okay? Next time now blast it. Now blast it, let it off. That's fantastic. Boys, girls, we have one more shot each. Make it tell. Okay, shorten the grip. Get the angles right. Run in, look. Watching. Watching. Ball your hand. Turn the hip. Let fly. And face up for the catch. Get the ball under the crossbar now. Good powerful shot in there. A good powerful shot in there. Liam, you're on. Hurley short. Turn. Under the line. Go again. So we get control. The stroke is good. Everything is really right. Under the line. Catch. Yes. He caught it on the belly button. That's fantastic. Well done. Well, girl, that's out now, you're at it. That's more like it now. Well, girl, keep coming. Well, girl, you're doing really well. That was some catch. That was catch. That's what we call catch. Liam, catch. Reaction, Liam. Catch. Reaction. You have the stroke, now we're on to reaction after the stroke. Otherwise it's golf, do you understand? Do you understand that idea? Not hurling. Good boy! Good boy. Catch, 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 catch. Shorten the stick and catch. Okay, we'll see which line will be the first to get four catches. No cheating, coaches. The coach's ego is not hanging on this. Is that okay?
Perfect.
Now, so we're going to go now until some team gets four catches. Not in a row, just four. We have one. Get back for the whistle. We have one. We have two. The show's nearly over here. We have three. Could she do it? How much money is on Cheltenham now? I mean, the white bag for balls there.
Something's coming, so.
Ah.
If we can go for another tour
trip. No, I'll do it. I'm finished.
Would you say what size the 100 something?
Oh, we've done that 100 times, yeah. Okay, all in. Hold on to the ball until we find the bag. Come in around me now, children first, and coaches outside or surround them. Good girl. Will you walk around there and make sure everyone is in? We'll have no cheats and robbers and frauds. Come in around me, children. In around me, children, and coaches behind them on their shoulder. Now, shh. Okay. Tune in now. So all the girls here, you're very careful about the size of your shoes and the size of your clothes. It matters dearly to you, doesn't it? Doesn't it? So you don't go around in size 10s if you're a 5. You don't do it. And that's a size 10 Hurley. It's a size 10 Hurley and weight is 12. So I don't know, Emer. But whether you have imagined that you've been in the gym for 20 years or something, you'd need to be in the gym for 20 years to swing that. It's impossible. It'll make you slow and it gimps your swing. It cannot be worked. It cannot be worked to the way she wants. Mind yourself there, lovey. It's throwing her whole body out of line. It doesn't matter how much coaching she's doing, she's going to be. Now pretend you have the ball there. Shorten it a small bit, get control. Now, pretend you have the ball, swing. Now, you see the lightness of that in your hand? Now you can afford to swing, because this one has to be lifted. She can't swing, she has to lift it. It's a big effort, it's slowing everything down. So let's rip it down now again. Now, run and strike. See the speed come back into the stroke, and this is destroying the girl, and she's madly in love with it. Okay? And we're all the same. Whatever is happening in the parishes, the young children think big hurley, big stroke. But of course they don't get any stroke. That's the end of it. This, in a match, would get no stroke. And she'd play a whole match and she'd have no stroke and no reward for playing the match. And this is her greatest enemy, and she thinks That is great stick. You know, I mean, it really isn't fit for the fire. You know what I mean? Anything that would destroy you must be your enemy, mustn't it? Now, that'll be grand for an intercounty hurler. There's nothing wrong with the timber or the hurley or the maker. It's a beautiful hurley, but not for you. That's for a boy of 6'2", right? That's a boy of 6'2" who has been in the gym for 6 or 7 years. Now, I'm just going to look for the small. Have you the smallest hurley there? Good girl. Hold on to that there, because I couldn't dare possibly have it on my conscience that I give it back to you. Ball. Where's the lady with all the bag of balls? She's gone. Now, watch. This hurley, which is a 30, you're much better off at a 28 than a 30. So it's 30, but where am I holding it? Why? Because that's the amount of space and time allowed in a modern match. So I spent last week with a couple of county hurlers who have 32-inch hurleys, and they hold them there, 3 inches in from the end. They're 32-inch hurleys. They've been in the gym for the last 7 years. And I said, what are you doing? Well, they said to me, the way it's gone, the amount of space you have. You come in with an old hurley, long hurley now, says you'd get no puck. So this hurley will hit the ball any distance. It'll hit it any distance. It'll hit the ball over from a 65. You give that to Patrick Horgan, and he'll put it over the bar from a 65. He can even go back to the other 65 and put it over the bar with that. So you must convince the children that a big hurley, a heavy hurley, is not the one that hits the ball far. It's the light, small one that gets the head speed. The head speed is all that matters. The head speed is the boss speed. Everything is about the boss speed. If you get the boss speed, the ball will go a mile. I'm giving up on you as well. Whatever you do, don't play in the goal next year. Did you see it? Dropping in under the crossbar. Did you see it? Under the crossbar. Another goal for Tip. So it's the head speed. It's how much speed can I generate on the boss that makes things. And the big heavy hurley makes the whole thing so slow that you cannot generate the speed that makes the ball go. That'll make the ball go. Another goal for Tipperary. And he still has his hands in his pocket. So it's the girls and the boys here who, coming from an older tradition when hurling was played with heavy hurleys. Lord, that's 60 years ago, 70 years ago now. It's even before my time. Do you understand? It's even before my time. Why did it linger? It has lingered, hasn't it? And the boy goes off to the plough match and all his savings since his first communion, and he buys a Joe Canny. Huh? And then he puts it in the trailer to bring it home, it's so heavy. So it's, yeah. And I love Joe Canny, right? And I think he's a phenomenal hurler. I think he makes a beautiful shape of a hurley. But he makes them every single size. I don't have to buy the biggest one.
Like the girls, what size hurley?
I'm going to do it now. Here we go. So I'm trying to convince that this is the smallest hurley in the group, and I'm in now. How much am I down now? I'm down to 26 now. So here am I, TJ Reid, in the All Ireland final. Locked. A real match, locked. Okay? Walter throws the ball back to TJ Reid, who holds a 32, and he's 8 inches in from the end. So what is he now? 24, wins the ball, roof of the net, in 0.8 of a second. If he was 0.9, he'd have got caught from behind and caught from in front. So he had all the mathematics worked out. I have within 0.1 of a second, sorry, I have within 1 second to strike this. Catch, turn, stroke. At 0.9, the Galway man chasing from behind was in. And at 1 second, the two boys from front were in. So had he a long hurley, and the All-Ireland gone a different way. We're in the fastest game in the world, played in the least amount of time possible, and the stroke has to come inside the body. It has to come back inside the body. It has to come back in there. And you're back in business, right? No, you're back in goals. So the boy and girl that's coming from here will never get the ball hit. And that's the enjoyment in the game. Striking the ball is the enjoyment. That's the addictive spot there. Right? So that ball will never get struck. 3 or 4 people will come between me and the ball. Just run in there now. Just run in.
Just stand in. You don't have to do anything now. I'm useless now. If I hit him now, it's a red card, I'm gone. He doesn't have to be able to hurl to beat me sick. Just run in again when I throw it up. He'll beat me sick off the park by doing nothing because I'm so beatable. Now, go back there again. Come in. See? He hadn't even, his foot lifted and had the ball gone. So the boys here could learn and the girls could learn to play this kind of hurling or this kind of hurling. What do we want? Okay. Give me your hurley there. Now I'm going to size hurleys now. I'm going to size hurleys and weight hurleys. So, if the child stands with their feet shoulder width apart and the shoulder square and the hands hanging and catch the hurley, that's the size hurley for me. I'm 6 foot tall. Watch me. Feet shoulder width apart, shoulders there, stand there, grab. That's my size hurley. Right? The next thing is weight. Can I move that hurley up and down with no tension on my face and with no wobble in the hurley? Of course I can do this if I like. I love it. You're not getting it. This is what I'm talking about. Can I rise that hurley without a gimmis on one muscle? Then it suits me. So this hurley suits me weight-wise and length-wise. Who's the owner? Are you 6 foot?
No.
So we're going to size this now. This is a great girl. She made fantastic progress today. A smart girl. Shoulders, feet shoulder width apart. Another bit. Now, drop the hands, head up, grab. Now, go again. Grab. Bring it up. So the next hurley she's buying has to be 4 inches shorter than that one. What's that? 35?
32.
32, is it?
Yeah.
So this is the size that she needs to fit her body. So when I go into the shop, I don't say, well, my friend wears size 4, I better get size 4 shoes. Do you get it? I don't think anybody would do that because you'd have sore toes in the morning, wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? There's no point in copying what your friend has. So watch her again now. Shoulders flat, feet shoulder width apart, head up, drop the hands, grab, bring it up, measure it. Well, 2.5 inches off that, which for her is a 29.5. Now she will get head speed. Now we'll see the weight.
That last night's presentation was just out of this world. This morning's session for an hour and a half, an hour and 3/4. Can't stop the man. And again, there today, some of the girls are saying just the time flew by. They couldn't believe it. I think what we can take from the club going forward is something massive from this. There's a small token from Clonakilty.
Have I a frying pan near me?
I know you went to Derry and you got Seamus Heaney signed book, but we'll give you a bit of Clonakilty to take away with you.
Lovely. So, and Martin, thank you so much.
We might just get everybody, we'll turn around and maybe you might get them in the tent. If everyone just comes in behind, then we'll just get a group
for us. If I sat down, I mightn't be able to get up, girls, but sure. I'll try and get down and let you see in the picture. That knee.
Everybody
try and
group in there, please.
Well done, girls.
Some of the people along the front, will you get down and
Well done. Well done. Had you a good time?
Yeah.
Coaches in at the back, please.
Well done.
Super.
So pretty. Now, are we all right?
We're all right.
Have we the sizzlers on?
Okay. Everybody, look at me. Look at me and sausages.
Sausages.
One more.
Clonakilty sausages.
Everybody, look at me. Sausages.
Sausages.
Beautiful.
Well done.
All right. Guys, there's 18.